Yeah, of course. Here it's a jnana place, so everybody talks about consciousness, consciousness, consciousness. That you should put your attention to consciousness and become come to the pure consciousness. Actually, even the pure consciousness is not yet quite that, but that's all we can aim at. It's the first expression of that mystery of existence. Pure consciousness, but it's not the only one. In the jnani place, usually they don't talk about anything else, but there are three things. There is the pure consciousness, and there is that pure love, and there is the pure force of life. The prana, the shakti, the adipara shakti, the force of life. And you can come back to that center, to the self, to existence, to God, whatever you want to call it, by focusing more on one of the three, and it leads to the same point. The jnani is focusing mainly on consciousness, trying to observe the mind, trying to detach from the thoughts, trying to be in pure consciousness. The yogi is focusing more on prana, on the force of life, through the yoga exercises, through the pranayamas, becoming more and more aware of the subtle current of life, being capable of undoing the knots that are there in the body and tuning into the cosmic prana, as the prana is balancing out the mind, quietens down by itself. The devotee starts with love. And first, the difficulty with love is that there are different things that are called love. there is the emotion love. And people start with the emotion. But the emotion is, by definition, changing all the time. It comes in waves, it has a peak, it goes. Sometimes people try to start to love everybody emotionally the same. It's becoming completely neurotic. You can't. Emotions, they change all the time by definition. You can have an emotional love pouring out to somebody for some time, but then it cools down again, and then it comes again. You can pour it to somebody else. It's not something that is just there, evenly distributed. It can't. It goes against what love is. But still, the devotee may start out very emotionally, that God and I and being very emotionally devoted to God, but through that emotion the heart starts to open, and the devotee will start to more and more touch that divine presence. Be aware of the divine presence more and more, whatever they are doing, whatever, wherever they go. And that divine presence is that same sense of presence that jnani may touch when he asks, "Who am I?" They have to come together, the different paths, but you can have a preference for one or the other. You can be mainly intellectual, and then you invariably will rather approach through jnana. But if then on the way the heart is not opening, that jnana remains very superficial. We can talk philosophy for hours and be basking our jnana, but it remains very superficial. But the same thing is with the devotee. If that devotion remains simply emotional, then it always remains a little bit a show for everybody else, trying to show everybody else how humble I am and how devoted I am. If that clear thinking doesn't come, if that discrimination is not developing, that devotion remains very superficial. And the yogi the same can do lots of exercises and lots of pranayamas and gradually become a bit aware of the current of life, but if the heart is not opening, then this remains very superficial. Even if the yogi develops some unusual powers that the experience will still be small. It will be still that me, I'm a person separate from the whole rest of the universe. If you go sincerely on one path, then the others somehow start to join in all by itself. If that is not happening, then it doesn't go very deep. You can start exclusively on one, or you can from the beginning combine as you feel what is most natural for you. People are different, so they are looking in a different way for truth. But if the sincerity is there, somehow the three start to come, flow together, and you come to that first primordial expression of beingness, and that's all we can do, somehow approach that. From here, from this point, there is no way that you can make an effort or something to go beyond it, but you can make yourself available by coming that far.